Hey guys, Taylor here. Today I'm going to show how to use the mobile phone control on RingRoost to connect your mobile device with your PBX. So there's really two parts of this that we'll look at today. First is the mobile phone control that we use in RingRoost, and the second is the RingRoost mobile app. And this app you can download for the iPhone or the Android. If you don't have either of those devices or don't want to download the app, you can simply go to m.ringroost.com and get all the exact same functionality. The only difference is basically there'll be the browser bar and the app might just run a little slower. So download it if you do have an iPhone or Android. But otherwise you can go to m.ringroost.com and I'll show you how to do that in a second. But so the basics of this works like any other control. We'll drag and drop an answer call control to handle the inbound call. And then we'll use the advanced control, the mobile phone control. We'll connect this like we would any other control. That just means when the call comes in, now we're going to connect, we're going to send the flow to the mobile phone. So here is where you need to put your mobile phone number. And this needs to be a phone number provided by your cellular carrier. So you still need to have a carrier, a mobile carrier, usually AT&T, Verizon, T-Mobile, something along those lines. So we still send the calls from RingRoost over those carriers. So I'll just put an example number in here. It's not my real number, but just so you can get an idea of how it works. And you need to make sure this is your real number. Otherwise, it won't work when you're trying to make and receive calls from the mobile application. And I'll get more into that into a second. But so make sure you have your correct number in here. Otherwise, it won't work. So extension, this is just going to be any extension you want, and you can use this. You can, kind of like this SIP phone control, you can, from anywhere else in your PBX, you can dial the extension, and it will ring this particular mobile device. So the friendly name is simply a name so you can identify which mobile phone you're connecting to. So the caller ID, this is important, is the number that will show up when you call people. So generally you want this to be your whatever your business phone number is. And the inbound caller ID is the caller ID that will show up on your phone when a particular call comes in. So depending on how you want to set it up, you can either set it up so you see whoever's calling, or you can set it up so it's always one particular number that's calling you. I'm going to set it up so it's actually one particular number that's calling me. That way I always know that the call is coming from RingRoost rather than, say, a friend or somebody. So the voicemail box is whatever voicemail box you want the call to go to if it's not answered. You can record the call, and this is how many times the phone will ring when a call is coming in, how many times your phone will ring before it sends them to voicemail. And so the incoming call message, so the way this works is a little bit different than you might be traditionally used to. When the call comes in, your phone will ring. You'll see, in this case, this particular number show up. And when you pick up the call, you're not going to be immediately connected. What you'll hear is call from, and it'll be the name of the person calling, press 1 to answer. If you don't press 1, it automatically gets sent to the voicemail box in this example. So the reason for that is if we automatically connected the call, then whoever was calling would hear your personal voicemail message, and we don't want that. So we want them to hear your business voicemail message. So I'm going to save this, and let me just show you a quick example. I'm going to make a call to, just so you can hear what this sounds like. Let me turn that down. My phone's ringing. Oops. See if I can turn that up. Put it on speed.
Press 1 to answer. Call from Taylor Hawks. Press 1 to answer.
Now I'm going
to
hang up.
Call from Taylor Hawks.
Hi. Thanks for calling RingRoost. Please leave us a message with your name and telephone number.
So you'll see, as soon as I hung up, the caller started hearing my business voicemail message. And that was actually my personal cell phone that was ringing. So that's the basics of how that works. Had I pressed 1 rather than hanging up, the call would have been connected. So I'm going to save this, and then I'm just going to walk a little bit through kind of just the basics of how to use the actual RingRoost application. So you'll log in with whatever your RingRoost login and password is, your email and password. And I have a demo account here. I think I can remember the... guess it's okay if somebody sees mine. Okay, so Tazephone. So once you log in, you'll have to select which mobile phone is yours. It's under mobile devices. I'm going to say this is me, and now you can see it brings us to the dial pad. So from here, I could go ahead and dial any number I wanted and make a call. And when you click this button to make a call, what'll happen is it'll actually use your carrier. So it'll pop up on your phone and you'll be able to make the call. And what you'll see is kind of a long string of digits, and it'll actually initially call whatever your caller ID is, and then it'll append the number you're calling. And we just do that so that we can set the appropriate caller ID on the outbound call, basically. So under here you can see you have voicemails, and I just left a couple demo ones. The red simply means that it hasn't been listened to, so you can click play and...
Hi, this is an example voicemail.
And hear the voicemail, and once it's been played, then it'll turn away from red. You can check your call history. I don't have too many, just made a few calls here. Sorry, back to voicemail real quick. So if you want to call the user back, simply swipe left and you can click call back. And of course you can delete the voicemail. Since I've listened to this one, I'll go ahead and delete it. Under our history, we can just see our call history. Similar thing, you can delete it or you can actually add to contacts. I'll show you that in a second. So under contacts, we have kind of all our contacts. You can just look at the contacts. You can see their name and phone number. Let's see. So if you wanted to add to contacts, you can come here and you can add a particular contact. I'll just say Bill or whatever. And the other thing you can do with contacts is you can actually add a tag to your contacts. And what this is you can also do this through the web portal, but it's simply a quick tag. So you could just do something like notes and, blah, blah, blah. Just take some notes, and you can use any key value for the tags. I won't go too much into that. Those are tags. That's the basics of using the RingRoost mobile app. If at any point you want to try and you need to update, for instance, your voicemail, simply drag it down, and it'll refresh, and any new voicemails will come in. Same thing with the history. And the contacts. So it's as simple as that. That's how you use the mobile phone app. And you can do some other fun things with this. So for example, if you have, let's say you have an office phone that you've set up and you miss the call on your office phone, then you can simply direct it to a particular mobile phone. Also, let's say the first mobile phone is missed, rather than sending it to voicemail automatically, you could send it to another mobile phone. So if you have more than one employee at your company, you could do something like that. So those are the basics of the mobile phone control. Thanks. Bye for now.